What did in that Nabi do for us? Which stone did he leave unturned for the sake of his ummah? Go today to Mecca and Medina and listen with the ears of Iman, and wallah, in the alleys and gullies of Mecca and Medina, you will hear the cry of that Nabi, Ya Rabbi, Ummati, Ummati, Ya Rabbi, Ummati, Ummati. Go and stand on the mountain of Taif and hear those stones tell you the waqia of what happened. To the most beloved of Allah, pelted and pelted and pelted, rock upon rock, stone upon stone, falling onto his Mubarak body till eventually his flesh split open and the blood started pouring out. He would fall to the ground, they would pick him up and force him to carry on running so that they could carry on pelting him and pelting him and pelting him. 3 miles, 3 miles till eventually overtaken, he turns to Allah, Allahumma inni ashku ilayka du'fa quwwati wa qillata hilati wa hawani 'ala an-nas ila man takiluni. Oh my Allah, to whom have you handed me over? Oh my Allah, to whom have you handed me over? To these ruffians who have pelted me so that the blood is pouring from my body, who have reduced me to this state. Oh my Allah, إِن لَمْ تَكُنْ عَلَيَّ سَاخِطًا فَلَا أُبَالِي. If you are not angry with me, then I am not worried. Then I am prepared to accept whatever you have done, oh my Allah. لَيْتَكَ تَحْلُو وَالْأَيَامُ مَرِيرَةٌ وَلَيْتَكَ تَرْضَى وَالْأَنَامُ غِضَابُ وَلَيْتَ الَّذِي بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَكَ عَامِرُ وَبَيْنِي وَبَيْنَ الْعَالَمِينَ خَرَابُ. Like the poet says, oh my Allah, if my relationship with you is intact and the whole world is against me, I am not worried. Oh my Allah, if you are happy with me and the rest of humanity is angry with me, I am not worried. Come back into the shade of Allah. Come back towards the mercy of Allah. In Uhud, Sahaba showed what the love for Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was. He asked them, where is Sa'd bin Rabi'? They can't find Sa'd bin Rabi'. Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam says to Zayd bin Haritha, go and look for Sa'd. He looks amongst the living, he cannot find him. Finally he comes across the body of Sa'd, lying on the battlefield of Uhud. Wabihi ramak, in the last breath of his life. He says, oh Sa'd, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has sent me to you. And he's asking, kayfa ajiduka? Oh Sa'd, in what condition are you? In that last breath of his life, he says, oh Zayd, abligh qawmi, abligh nabiyyi minka salam. Convey my salams to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Convey my salams to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And tell him, ajiduni, ajidu rihal jannah. I find myself in a condition that I can smell the fragrance of Jannah. I can smell the fragrance of Jannah. Tell him, may Allah reward him more than any other Nabi has ever been rewarded. In the last gasp of life, they were not interested in the properties of this world and in the attractions of this world. They knew the reality of the love for Allah and his Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In his last gasp of life, he grabs hold of the hand of Zayd and he says, Abliq qawmi minni salam. And O Zayd, convey my salams to my people. And tell them that Sa'd said, La udhra lakum in khulisa ila nabiyikum wa fikum aynun tatruf. That Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is harmed. And you are still alive. Tomorrow in the court of Allah, I will hold you responsible in front of Allah. This was love for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This was ishq. This was muhabbat. With what ease today, with what ease today, his ummati takes that razor and shaves off his sunnah. With what ease today, do those statements come on the lips? It is only sunnah, so it is okay to leave it out. Have we forgotten the pelting of Taif? Have we forgotten how he fell unconscious in Uhud? Have we forgotten how he tied stones to his Mubarak stomach for the sake of this ummah? Have we forgotten his days and nights? Ya Rabbi ummati ummati, Ya Rabbi ummati ummati, Ya Rabbi ummati ummati. Oh my Allah, my
حينما رددت يا رب العباد وانتهت روحي وصار الدمع يجري يا إلهي خذ بقلبي للرشاد.
So that even tomorrow on the plains of Arafat, April, he stood on the back of that camel, raise his hand up to the heavens. We go to Arafat, go look at the Hujjaj in Arafat. How long is the dua of Arafat? 30 minutes, 40 minutes, 45 minutes, 50 minutes. How long is the dua of Arafat? May we be sacrificed on that Nabi, on the back of that camel, in the burning sun of the desert. 6 hours he cried for this ummah. 6 hours, with his hand raised above his head. Sahaba say he would reach out, bring it back, reach out, bring it back. And then Allah says, oh my Nabi, I have forgiven the oppressed of your ummah. He says, Ya Allah, that is not enough. Allahumma innaka qadir ala an tusiba hadha al-mazloom wa taghfir li hadha al-zalim. Oh my Allah, don't forgive only the mazloom. Oh Allah, you have the power to repay the mazloom from your treasures and to forgive the zalim also. Forgive the zalim of my ummah also. Forgive the zalim of my ummah also. Tomorrow on the day of judgment, that day when people will be swimming in their own perspiration, that day when anbiya will fall onto their knees begging Allah for the mercy of Allah. Ka'b Ahbar radiallahu ta'ala anhu says, when Jahannam screams on the day of judgment, that scream will be so frightening that if you had the amal of 70 Nabis, you will still think Allah is going to throw you into Jahannam. 5 great Anbiya amongst the galaxy of Anbiya, 5 great Anbiya. Nuh alayhi salam, Ibrahim alayhi salam, Musa alayhi salam, Isa alayhi salam, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. From these 5 Anbiya, the other 4, Ya Rabbi Nafsi Nafsi, Ya Rabbi Nafsi Nafsi, Adam alayhi salam, Ya Rabbi Nafsi Nafsi, Shis alayhi salam, Nuh alayhi salam, Lut alayhi salam, Salih alayhi salam, Ibrahim alayhi salam, Isa alayhi salam, Musa alayhi salam, Ismail alayhi salam, Yunus alayhi salam, Harun alayhi salam, Nabi upon Nabi, Ya Rabbi Nafsi Nafsi, Ya Rabbi Nafsi Nafsi, so that Ibrahim alayhi salam also would say, Ya Allah, save me from Jahannam. So that Isa alayhi salam will say, Ya Allah, la asaluka ummi Maryam, I am not asking you even to save my mother Maryam from Jahannam, save me from Jahannam. Only one individual, one personality on one side of Maidan-e-Hashr will be crying, and his cry will be a different cry. Ya Rabbi ummati ummati, Ya Rabbi ummati ummati, Ya Rabbi ummati ummati. Have we forgotten the ihsan of that Nabi? Do we prefer the ways of his enemy over his way? Cry tears of blood. If in this heart the azmat of one way of the Yahud and Nasara is more than the azmat of Sunnat. Cry tears of blood. If you see honor and dignity in the appearance of the Yahud and Nasara and do not see it in the appearance of my Nabi who finished himself for you. Tomorrow on the day of judgment, how are we going to face him? When legion upon legion of Sahaba, some with their ears cut off, some with their nose cut off, some with their chest ripped open. Lawnuhu lawnu dam, wa rihuhu rihu misk. The color will be the color of blood and the smell will be the smell of musk. They will be coming one by one in front of Allah. Tomorrow on the day of judgment, how are we going to face it? When on Arafat, when he gave this ummah the zimmedari and the responsibility of tabligh of this deen, he exhorted them, La tusawwidu wajhi yawm al-qiyamah, in fulfilling this responsibility of propagating my deen to the 4 corners of the world, do not become a source of embarrassment to me on the day of judgment. Allah will say to him, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what do you want? Ask, it will be granted. He will say, Ya Allah, begin the hisab. Begin the hisab, my ummah cannot wait anymore. They are suffering too much. Riwayat comes, pulpits, thrones will be sent down for the Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam. Anbiya will be sitting on their thrones. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, when my throne comes, I will not sit on it, because I fear that by sitting on it, it may take me away to Jannat. And if I go into Jannat, what will happen to my ummah? He says, I will not break the order of Allah also. I will place my hand on the throne, but I will not sit on the throne. And I will beseech my Allah, Ya Rabbi Ummati, Ummati. Ya Rabbi Ummati, Ummati. And he will carry on beseeching, and he will carry on begging until finally Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says, Allah will give him permission that go into Jahannam also and take your ummah out of Jahannam. He says, I will carry on going and I will carry on begging Allah until Malik, the keeper of Jahannam, will say, Ya Muhammad, ma tarakta li ghadabi rabbika fi ummatika min niqma. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you have not left any chance for the anger of your Rabb on your ummah. Such a Nabi, which facet of the ummah today is a source of coolness to that Nabi? The youth, the shamelessness of the youth of this ummah is like an arrow that is being fired at that Mubarak heart in Medina Munawwara. The shamelessness and the openly parading in the bazaars of the daughters and mothers of this ummah is like an arrow that is being fired at that Mubarak heart in Medina Munawwara. The lies and treachery and deception of the businessmen of this ummah is like an arrow that is being fired at that Mubarak heart in Medina Munawwara. May we be sacrificed on that Mubarak Nabi. 1 billion arrows. 1 billion arrows being fired at his heart. And still he is saying, Ya Rabbi Ummati, Ummati. Ya Rabbi Ummati, Ummati. My respected brothers, it's not my intention to speak very long. We don't know if you will live to see another Ramadan. We don't know if you will see the Hilal of Eid also. Every one of us in this gathering, these nights are given to us for sincere tawbah. From the bottom of our hearts, from the bottom of our hearts, make sulah with Allah. Make sulah with Allah and ask Allah from the bottom of our hearts, Oh my Allah, you forgive me. We know the wrongs, we know the treacheries, we know what is going on in our homes and what is going on in our lives. But make that sincere intention that we will make 100% attempt to come unto the obedience of Allah. And first and foremost, from now till I die, I will not make another salah qaza. 5 times salah I will make in the masjid. And make tawbah from the bottom of the heart that we have turned our back on the day of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the night of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the cry and concern of Rasulullah Pak sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And on this Mubarak night, make ahad, oath, throw ourselves in the court of Allah, that Ya Allah, you accept me like you accepted Sahaba. Accept my wealth, accept my life, and take me to the four corners of the world to raise your name and the name of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah Ta'ala give each and every one of us tawfiq.